year the volleyball team is coached by Sherry Barber. They were 14-6 in the regular season. In postseason, they defeated Strasburg in round one of sectionals and fell to Highland in four close sets at the sectional championship.
Peter, so I probably I shoot the diamond, and I looked and I saw Sancho versus Donovan, and I saw someone said, from Madonna said, Madonna has too many weapons, both in the running game and the passing game. Central cannot cover our receivers, nor can they stop both number 2 and number 26. The only good player Central has is Colabella, but he isn't as good as Combs. Central's running backs and wide receivers are average, O-line and D-line small. He will not be able to pass against our secondary. The stand will be going to end in the fourth quarter because McDonald will win by 4 touchdowns. I don't believe that. I believe we are truly the better team here. We play Crusader football, and we play with the tradition that we have in heart, I know that we will come out on top. But as a team, we have way too many weapons for them to stop us. Now, I personally don't like Madonna. I can't stand that. And tomorrow, when we go down the weird, for the first time in a long time, I hope we finally shut them up.
Central football, anyone down here, any one of these players, we've never beaten Madonna. And seniors, this is our last chance. Tomorrow night is our last chance to ever go up against the Blue Dogs. Alright? A lot of people like to talk. A lot of people say, we don't have a chance. They're too good. They're better than us. But you know what? I don't like to listen to those kind of people. Because what I think is, Madonna, they had their chance. Their time's over. They had their time to be great. It's our time now. It's our time to bring back the central tradition, central pride, the heart of what it means to be a crusader. Tomorrow night, I know, we all have to play as a union, as a family, as brothers. All you guys down here, you're all my brothers. I'll do anything for you. All right? We're going to come together in one unit. You get to give everything you have, every single play. This game's not going to be easy. We aren't just going to roll our helmets out and beat them. We've got to get everything we have, every single play. I know everybody in this entire area knows who the better team is. Tomorrow night, we go down to the weird. Let's prove to the Blue Dogs, to all the doubters, to everyone who hates us, everyone who thinks we're scrubs, let's prove to them that we're the better team. Thank you. Thank you.
Very well. I'd like to also thank everybody involved in putting the pep rally together and like to make a comment, first of all. You know, there's just been a buzz, a feeling of excitement this whole week, you know, throughout the hallways here, that I can honestly say has not been felt in quite some time. And it's an exciting thing. It's a thing that we need to hold on to and just keep riding with it, okay? Because it's a great thing to be walking these hallways and learning to feel that. Now this week it is a very big game, okay? But the approach we've taken this week is no different than any other week. And what we've tried to tell these guys is we're not going to make it bigger than what it is. It's a big enough game on its own, okay? So our approach has been exactly the same. We haven't changed anything we've done, practice plan-wise or anything, okay? We've approached it the same way we've approached the previous 8 weeks. Now, Madonna has a very, very good football team. I give them all the respect in the world, okay? But I would sit it right on the head. We have the better football team, and I firmly believe that. I'm going to let you in on a secret a little bit here. I usually don't tell people what my game plan is for the week, but I'm going to let you know in a second here. You know, going throughout the course of the week, you know, it can be really exhausting to read, okay? As Ryan said, all the stuff that's posted on websites or on blogs and so on, reading the newspaper, watching things on TV, all the hype, all the build-up to it. But you know what? Games are not won or lost on social media, on websites, in the newspaper, or on the paper itself. Games are won or lost on the field, okay? So come 7 o'clock tomorrow night, it's either time to put up or shut up, okay? Because that's where the game's going to be won. Now, as far as game plan goes, it's very, very simple. It's very simple. It's 7-0 versus 8-0, okay? And the game plan is this. I'm going to do everything in my power, our coaches are going to do everything in their power, and these guys down here are going to do everything in their power to make sure, okay, somebody has to lose, and it ain't going to be us. It's not going to be us. Hey, we'll be in all white tomorrow, one team, one heart. You guys being all white, one school, one heart. Let's go over there and let's wreck Madonna. Go Blue.
And finally, he has spirit. A strong, rowdy uproar will rise, and the dawn won't know it hit them. Yes, they may think they have us beat, but we know otherwise.
Thank you. We have a few minutes left, so I just want to make a few comments before I dismiss you for the day. I'm a big fan of athletic movies, you know, like Rudy, Friday Night Lights, movies like that. But my favorite one is Remember the Titans. It was on cable a couple of, I think last week, I think I watched it 2 or 3 times last week. And I really like that movie. And especially the last scene when they're playing for the state championship. And of course they've lost their star linebacker who was involved in an accident, which is a true story, by the way. And, you know, they're in the locker room and they're losing. It's halftime. And, you know, coach is saying, you know, you're doing your best. Win or lose, you know, we're going to be proud of you. You know, just go out in the second half, do the best that you can. He was sort of already giving in that, you know, T.C. Williams High School was going to lose this game. And, you know, one of his players said, Coach Boone, excuse me. He said, with all due respect, you've demanded perfection from us. And up to this point, we've been perfect. We've won every game. And that's what Coach Daly and his staff and our football team has given us up to this point, a perfect season, 8-0. First time since 1971. It's a long time. And that player said, and if you don't mind, he says, that's the way I'd like to end this season, by being perfect. And that's the way we're going to end our season, by being perfect. Now, they made all of these adjustments at halftime because this team came out in a spread offense and they're throwing the ball all over, and T.C. Williams, they weren't prepared for that. So at halftime, they made all of these defensive adjustments. And the defensive coach had them all in the huddle on the sideline after they made all their adjustments. And he told his players, never let them forget the night they played the Titans. Tomorrow night, let them never forget the night they played the Crusaders.
Juniors, you're excused. See all of you at the game tomorrow night.